This video is brought to you by Squarespace, the online platform to build your website or get your domain. Head over to squarespace.com/Emilio, use the coupon code Emilio, and get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. Hey everybody, today we're gonna see how we can create the time freeze or time stop effect in Final Cut Pro 10 without any plugins required. This effect is inspired by Kyler Holland, who made a version for Adobe Premiere. Let's go into Final Cut Pro 10 and see how we can create this super slow motion time speed effect. We are in the Final Cut Pro 10 interface, and first, let's bring this clip down here and show you how easy it is to create this time stop, this time freeze, even if your video is not sat in the highest frame rate as possible. So we will work with a video sat in 24 frames per second. So this applies for videos in 24 frames per second or 25 frames per second. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit, Command plus to zoom in, and let's go and find where our subject is looking at us, as we did in the beginning of this video. All right. Okay, and we are around here. Okay, when we have the change. All right, here. I'm gonna press R in my keyboard, select the range tool, and I'm gonna select only one frame. Then I will go here and select the speed to custom and set it to 1%. And then what I'm gonna do, pressing A in my keyboards, and then go here and set the video quality to optical flow. The optical flow, basically what it does, gives us the ability to have a slow motion that it's not gonna be choppy slow motion. And let's see, I'm gonna turn this here more to the right. Let me just zoom in a little bit more, Command plus. Okay, so let's go and check the result. Now, as we can see, we see that the hair right here makes some funny changes while it's moving, right? So what we can do now is, let's go and find where the hair starts to be a little bit of strange, and where it's a little bit of normal. So as we can see here, we don't have a lot of movement in the hair area here. Not a strange movement, okay. So I'm gonna press B on my keyboard, I'm gonna blade this, I'm gonna select all the other portion here, and I'm gonna set to normal speed, and now check the result. Boom. This is more of a natural sequence, and you might see that with optical flow, you might have some choppiness, you might have some transitions between frames that they're not very natural to the eye. So this way we can go into the area that we want to create the time stop, but also the area that it's not gonna look unnatural. Let's see the other example with the carrots. I'm gonna place it here. On this is gonna be even more precise what I was talking before. Before we continue with the tutorial, let me take a moment and talk about Squarespace. I can't stress enough how important it is to have a website. So if you're a creator, if you're a videographer, photographer, video editor, you're a YouTuber and you don't have a website, website is a must. This is the way where you can showcase your portfolio, show your work, have an appearance in Google for SEO, or it helps for your videos if you're a YouTuber for the SEO ranking on the YouTube results. With Squarespace, you can use between high-end templates that you can use them as a structure, and even if you don't have any knowledge at all on web design or web developing, you can start creating your own website. So if you don't have a website and you were thinking on getting one, head over to squarespace.com/Emilio. You can try it for free first, and then when you're ready to buy, you can use the coupon code Emilio and get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. Also, by using the link that you will find in the description of this video down below, don't forget that you support this channel. Let's go back now into the video. Okay, let's play, and let's say that here we want the time stop to appear. Command plus, I'm gonna zoom in, I'm pressing R in my keyboard for the range tool, selecting one frame, custom speed 1%, A to select this clip. I'm gonna go to video quality, select the optical flow, and then wait for it to render. As soon as we see that it's rendered, let's play and see. Okay, pure madness right now. And as I told you before, we're trying to find an area where the slow motion is gonna look natural, okay? So from here, let's play and see from here. This area is natural enough, okay? So I'm gonna press M here to add a marker until the end of the movement. Let's say just before we see here that we're starting to see unnatural movements with the optical flow. So let's say until here, I'm gonna press again M in my keyboard to add a marker. I'm gonna press B on my keyboard, select the blade. I'm gonna cut here, and select this portion here on the left. Set it to normal, and this portion, set it to normal, and the result is gonna look like this. A very nice slow motion. Remember that it might work without the need of doing this. For example, let's go back into the first clip. If we select here, and let me zoom in, okay, and select now one frame, make it custom 1%, select the clip, video quality is optical flow, of course, because we did it in the first time. Let's see, we might have done it from the first time without the need to create these cuts with the blade tool to pick the right spots into the clip. We wait for it to render. Let me adjust this a little bit so it can be more quick, the transition into the slow motion, and let's see. You see now that it's working fine without the need to create any extra steps. Maybe here at the end we could cut it, so I can blade it here and then set all the rest to normal. That's one way. Or I can, let me zoom out a little bit, press R to select the range tool, select all the other portion and set it to normal, so I can have the transition as well here and adjust the transition. So with blade, I can blade it boom. With the range, I can also set the transition to slow or speed between the speed ramp. I show you two ways, one with the B, one with R, and of course, if we are lucky, without the need of any of these. And let's check it out. I hope you found this video helpful and you learned something new today. As you saw, it was a very easy process that you can use to create the time stop effect, the super slow motion 1%, even if you haven't sat in a highest frame rate, like 60 frames or 120 frames per second. I'm waiting you in the comment section down below. Let's continue the conversation there. If you have any questions or you just want to say hi, don't forget to subscribe and ring the notification bell, very important, to receive notifications every time I post a new video. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Emilio Takas, and I will see you in the next video.